Good evening, everybody. Welcome back to the Maitri Project. So Maitri is back, and this time with a bigger bang. We have such a good surprise for all of you that I can't begin to disclose, but we're going to reveal it step by step because that's the whole idea of Maitri, as you know. So welcome, good evening. My name is Sonia Swarup Choksi. I'm the co-founder and CEO of Match My Talent, a small organization dedicated completely to bringing networking access to performing artists. No matter where you are, what genre of performances you follow, but we're there as a technology company to support and to be able to grow your network. The Maitri Project is our initiative to introduce artists and their works to a larger network. And today, it is indeed a very special evening for all of us at Match My Talent because we have a very, very, very fine artist with us today. She's young, she's dynamic, she's self-made, and she's very, very versatile. And of course, she's an independent artist. But it is very heartwarming to see when an independent artist is no more sort of clutched into the usual kaise karein, kaise hoga, kya karein. But is finding the ways out, and you actually already see the person there at what we call as limelight, right? So let me introduce Sana Moerdithi to you. You've obviously seen her a lot on the YouTube and on the lovely music backgrounds that we all hear. And it's extremely special that Sana is going to be very candid today. So bring in your questions if you have any, but I have a lot to talk with her. So bringing in Sana. Hi, Sana.
Hi, how are you?
Hi. Very good. Welcome to the Maitri Project. It's so good to have you here.
Thank you so much.
Audience, there would be some lag in the internet. Can't help it. Please bear with it. It just keeps coming and going. So stick around and let us know if there is an issue. But we can't do anything because it's internet. So just hang in. Welcome, Sana. How have you
Internet
been?
plus rains.
Plus rains.
Good. By the grace of God, everything is going really good. How about you? How are
How?
you coping with the lockdown and everything?
Actually, we have become way more busier in the lockdown than we were because the jhadu pocha has gotten included in the day's work, which wasn't so earlier.
Yeah, so there's no boundary between work and, personal life now because of the lockdown. I guess everything just happens in the same space.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, so like my daughter says, like when she has her online classes, and initially she used to say, "Don't come in my frame," and I said, "Well, this is home. Can't help it. We are all in each other's frame." So now she also tells me, "This is home. What to do?" It's like, yeah, fair enough. This is home.
Correct.
How is it? How has it been for you, Sana? Like, I mean, just before the lockdown, you've been so pretty busy with making music, and like,
Correct.
I mean, what I would imagine your life would be to just be running around the studios and creating music, and suddenly you are at
Absolutely.
home. So, have you not made any music in this time at all?
No, actually, after once the lockdown began, I was as you know, I started staying with my parents after that. Before that, like I had a space to work, like a rented apartment where I had my setup and everything, and I used to work up from there. Because I wanted, a room of my own where, I was not disturbing anyone with a loud volume and things like that. So shifting back, the first thing was adjusting and getting a place where even my sister's also working from home. And plus I'm doing music. So, I need to adjust it in a way where I'm not disturbing my family and at the same time I'm able to do my work as well. So the first thing that happened was I changed my sleep cycle. I started working at night when everyone slept. So, that's when I shut the door and I shut everything and, I started making music then. And also I thought like, okay, I cannot go out and shoot because I put out content regularly on YouTube. But then with this happening, it was not possible to meet any team for, videography, or neither was it possible to go to a studio because a studio is an enclosed space where, you go and you sing in front of the mic. There's such close contact, if someone else has sung, and we all know this is like a droplet transmission disease and stuff like that. So I couldn't risk it, going out to a studio or going to a beautiful location and shooting. So the first thing I thought was, okay, my building terrace is safe. I can probably shoot something over there.
Oh,
And yeah,
that's so cool.
and that's how we started. And my sister, she is like, she has a good eye, you know, when it comes to photography and videography. So I said, why don't you shoot it? She works. In fact, she's not in this field, but then she's always been styling for me and, you know, doing art direction and
So
helping
she
me
has
out
that
with the theme
sense.
and stuff like that. Yeah. So she said, okay, let's try something. And then we went on the terrace and, you know, we had a phone gimbal. So she tried out some shots on that. We had some practice shots. And the audio, this was the first time I recorded something from home for a professional YouTube recording, or else I always go to a studio and I get all my songs recorded. But
Sure.
because I didn't want to risk it at all, not just that, we you know the studios were shut.
There was
So
no
I
option.
used like a basic SM58 mic and a basic, yeah, there was no option, and a sound card, like a Scarlett 2i2. And I work on Logic. The software that I work on is Logic. And I just recorded, like I had the IT with me. It was programmed by Prasanna Suresh. And I recorded it. Like I covered all my curtain rods with thick blankets so that, you know, I could cut down on all the reflections because the room isn't treated.
Obviously,
And
yeah.
luckily, you know, our bedrooms are always messy. So the mess helps to cut down all the reflections, you know, automatically. So
Good news,
that
you're
really
already
came to my advantage. Yeah. So yeah, like all the bachelor pads, you know, this is the time to make music because all the mess is going to help you now. So it was all messy. And at night everything is because you know, right? Because there's so much stuff, you're shifting things from my rented
Yeah.
apartment. There's a lot of things lying around. But luckily the recording came out, you know, decently, and I gave it to the mix engineer and I asked him, is it okay? He's like, yeah, it's fine. Like for now, we can definitely manage with such a recording.
Nice.
So I think this was a one of a kind experience. And not just that, I learned editing also with this. You know, I started
You
learning
edited
editing and I
your
edited
film.
my own video, like, for the first time. Like
Ah,
others, I
lovely.
edit. Yeah, I edited on Premiere Pro. So of course the shots were not very complicated because everything was on at one location. It was on the terrace. So that it was not like very complex and stuff, but I enjoy editing anyway. As a musician, I enjoy cutting visuals to the beat and things like that. So overall, it was a very nice experience, and I'll always cherish it. The first video that I made during lockdown times,
So
things
special.
like
I
that.
mean,
It's
so
simple,
amazing.
of course. It's not like very fancy, but I think like whatever can be done, I've
It
just
does the
tried.
work. It gets your music out.
I think there's a network.
Yeah, there's some
Was that? I
delay.
didn't get you because there was a network issue, and I think.
No, I was saying the
Yeah.
video does the work. It gets your music out.
Just
It's
try.
not about a great video. And I'm sure it's great. I have seen
Yeah,
it,
like,
but
of course, good visuals are important.
yeah. But it's there on Sana's YouTube channel. Her YouTube is by her
It's
name itself.
like whatever you can manage.
Yeah. I just want to know from the
Yeah,
audience.
it's a Malayalam cover. It's the song name is Chula Marichu.
Audience, I just want to know, is the audio completely okay for all of you, or do you want us to restart it? I am good, but I just want to get a heads up before we get deeper into the conversation. All good. Just a nice thumbs up or a smile is fine. We understand those emotions. No reaction is good reaction. Okay, great. So we're audible. Lovely.
Yeah.
So yeah, so
Yeah.
Sana's video is on her channel. So please do go and check it out. It's her Malayalam, I mean something completely independently done. And I really think that, you know, like thank you, Rohan. Thank you for that confirmation. So I really think, Sana, that you know, artists can end up doing a lot of things together because when you have the option, of course, you can be more choosy and you can say, okay, this is what my forte is, and you can go and just focus on that. But I mean, all the processes are so interlinked, right? Like the video and the audio, the syncing, the track, the visual, the B-roll and the C-roll.
Yeah.
It's something I think as creative people, we are always thinking of it in the mind, even if we're not doing that process, but it's there in the mind that, okay, this is how it will get
Yeah,
cut, and this
absolutely.
is, yeah, lovely. And I was thinking that, you know, when you're doing all these processes and taking out, I believe you're also an engineer, Sana, aren't you? You studied engineering.
Yes, hidden fact. I'm a computer engineer, and I enjoy that time. See, I was good at studies actually. I really enjoyed physics and maths and things like that. But
Wow.
I think I always needed something to balance out that nerdy side of me, which was music. And I sometimes feel ki yaar, I should go back to some physics and concepts because I really enjoyed back then. But now, of course, I'm out of touch and I don't. But I do read stuff related to science, but not as in depth as how much I'm studying music now because that's where my entire focus is. But yeah, I really like
Thank
had
God
that
music
side to
happened to
me.
you.
Had.
You would have been a boring engineer. We would have missed out on such great music.
Course, the
Nobody would,
engineers
we
are.
wouldn't have known you as an engineer. You would have been just like some sana somewhere. What would we have known? Nothing. Lovely.
Yeah, I think like to even to be able to do something well, you have to feel really happy about it. And I
Yeah.
wasn't very happy when I was coding, while doing computer engineering. And I was like, okay, I don't think this is what I want to do. So my friends, they sat for placement, but I was pretty clear that I don't want to sit for any placements. Once this is done, I'm going to start a new journey after this. So that's how it started.
So you knew it would be music? That new journey?
So yeah, because I was learning music since the age of 5 because my mom is a singer and she used to sing for shows and I used to accompany her for her rehearsals. And I used to, like when she used to catch the rhythm, I used to clap along or I used to try and hum and things like that. So she realized that, okay.
You have the interest.
And then I started learning.
Wow. So yeah, so I guess in the background you always knew that the other thing apart from physics and technology would be music for you. I am experiencing a lag from Sana, but she's gonna come back.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
I can, yeah, you're back.
Yeah. So no, I went back to my phone network because the
Okay.
Wi-Fi is acting funny. So what was the last thing that was
No, I was
that?
you were saying that you knew that you will be on a different journey, and I asked you that, did you know that it will be music?
So yeah, I didn't think of it as a I didn't really think that I would make a career out of it, to be very honest, when I was young. I thought, okay, ठीक है, कुछ करेंगे, ग्रेजुएशन, एमबीए, ऐसा कुछ तो सोचा था मैंने, बट एंड आई रियली डोंट हैव अ माइंड ऑफ माय ओन. आई लाइक, ओके, सब कर रहे, मैं भी करूंगी, दैट काइंड ऑफ अ थिंग. बट आई वाज लर्निंग म्यूजिक अलोंगसाइड ऑलवेज, एंड आई नेवर स्टॉप लर्निंग. इवन ड्यूरिंग माय बोर्ड एग्जाम्स, लाइक माय 10th, 12th, आई सॉ एवरीवन, दे जनरली दे स्टॉप देयर एक्स्ट्रा करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज व्हेन इट कम्स टू दीज इंपॉर्टेंट इयर्स, राइट? बट आई डिडंट बिलीव
कर्फ्यू
इन दैट. आई थॉट कि नहीं, ये कंटिन्यू मुझे करना है. 10th, 12th, जो भी हो, आई कीप लर्निंग बिकॉज़ दैट वाज समथिंग व्हिच ऑलवेज गेव मी पीस. सो दैट्स हाउ, आई केप्ट लर्निंग लर्निंग. इंजीनियरिंग के टाइम भी ऑल्सो आई केप्ट लर्निंग एंड आई मेट डिफरेंट गुरुजीज इन दैट जर्नी. लाइक आई फर्स्ट आई स्टार्टेड ऑफ विद कर्नाटिक क्लासिकल. एज आई सेड, इट वाज इनफॉर्मल ट्रेनिंग विद सुंदरी गोपाल कृष्णन. देन आई स्टार्टेड डूइंग हिंदुस्तानी क्लासिकल विद मधुवंती पेठे मैम. सो दिस वाज ड्यूरिंग माई स्कूल ईयर्स. Then I had the opportunity of training with Ustad Ghulam Mustafa Khan Saab. That was for a very short period of time though, like for 6 months or something. And then after that, I met Samantha Edwards. Like I took a little bit of training in Western music as well, contemporary, not Western classical, but contemporary Western. And now I'm learning advanced Hindustani classical from Sunil Borkamper. So I think the learning never stopped, and I constantly need something to stimulate my mind to be able to create more.
Amazing.
That's how
And
it
I
works.
and all these layers that you keep putting into yourself through the different genres that you play and through the different gurus, that I guess that's very reflective in the texture that you bring into your music, Sana. As an audience,
Thank
when
you.
I
Thank you so much.
listen to it, it's so your music is very, very textured. And I guess that's
Thank
because
you.
of the kind of things that you put in it. Lovely. So I think
Thank you.
the audience is going to beat me now because I can see audio, music coming in. We're going to continue chatting, but can we hear something from you at this moment?
Yeah, sure. So,
Yeah.
should I start with the latest song that I sang for my YouTube channel?
That would
Are
be
there
nice.
Malayalis in the audience? I'll just switch on my
Doesn't matter.
Tanpura.
The language doesn't
The
matter.
language doesn't matter.
Yeah,
Okay.
not at all.
Okay.
Never. Okay,
Cool.
great. So I'll see
Sounds
you in
good.
a bit.
Yes. So this was my last cover on my
Beautiful,
YouTube channel. Thank you.
beautiful, beautiful. Without any tracks and without any music, it sounds so good.
Thank you so much.
So, how many languages can you sing in?
So I think being a Malayali,
Huh.
it's easy to pick up other languages. So I have sung in Hindi, English, Malayalam, Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, Bengali, Marathi, Gujarati,
It's okay. It's okay, then I got it.
and sometimes
Basically,
Punjabi.
huh?
Yeah, but the thing is, I don't know these languages. Okay, I know
Yeah.
Malayalam, I know English, I know Hindi, I know Marathi, I know Gujarati. These languages I know. Like I can speak, I can manage like decently these
Conversation.
languages, conversations. But when it comes to singing, I need assistance. Like generally in the studio, there'll always be this person who will tell me, ki, okay, this means so and so,
This means.
and this is how you're supposed to pronounce it. So we'll always have someone in the studio who helps out with such things. So yeah, that's how it works.
On
Otherwise,
that
it's
note,
difficult.
can we hear something in a totally different language? Whatever is on your mind.
Okay, let's do. I found love for me, darling. Just dive right in and follow my lead. I found a girl, beautiful and sweet. I never knew you were the someone waiting for me. We were just kids when we fell in love, not knowing what it was. I will not give you up this time. Darling, just kiss me slow. Your heart is all I own, and in your eyes, you're holding mine. Baby, I'm dancing in the dark with you between my arms, barefoot on the grass, listening to our favorite song. When you said you looked a mess, I whispered underneath my breath, you heard it, darling, you look perfect. I don't deserve this, darling, you look perfect tonight. I love the song. I love Ed Sheeran. I love all his songs. And this has been the song that I always sing whenever someone tells me to sing something in another language.
And it's and the way you render it is so I mean, just is it belongs to you. The song belongs to you totally.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Very pleasant. I am always amazing. I'm like very bad with languages. I'm so bad that I wonder which wiring got completely missing that I can't go beyond Hindi and English. And so anybody who can speak or like be more communicative in the third language, I'm like, wow, kya matlab, sorted.
क्या
क्या बात है. So that reminds me, I wanted to, I was thinking about you the other day, and I was thinking that your life must be so sorted, Sana. Like, you're based in Bombay, which is like the
okay.
hub of entertainment. You've got a supportive family. A lot of time we meet a lot of artists, the first thing that gets missing for them is that, family doesn't support because it's art and
Exactly.
like people don't relate to it so much.
Yeah.
So that's great for you. Your mother is like sort of, I mean, she's an artist, so she'll appreciate it. I mean, you live a lot of the time people are all right, they're performing and stuff, but they're so far from a hub of entertainment that it's just like a dream,
Correct.
that it's not possible. I mean, you're
Right.
so versatile, you know so many languages, sing so beautifully, you look so
Thank
good.
you.
So
Thank you.
is there anything that could be another world for Sana? I mean, for us it's all sorted and perfect, and inshallah you should be just like climbing, climbing, climbing. But
Thank
what's
you so
your take
much.
to that?
I think yes, definitely there's I won't say that I'm not privileged enough, to be staying in Bombay. This is the city of entertainment and where everything is so glamorous, and you know how things work because I'm born and brought up here, so I know how it is. And I stay with my family, so I'm really lucky that my family is always around and I have a support system. But having said that, I don't think it's this industry is a tough industry. It's not simple to make your mark. Not that I've still made it. Like, I'm on my journey. But making a mark here is much more than talent. I mean, you have to be networking with people. You need to be very enterprising. Like, you have to keep promoting your work. You need to show people about your new work. And given that, like, we're living in the age of the internet, it's just not about socializing otherwise, but making content all the time and putting it up. So now internet has kind of erased those boundaries. Like, it doesn't matter whether you're from Bombay or you're from any other city or you're
That's
from
true.
any part of the world, but it has erased those boundaries, and that's the reason why you find viral hits from places probably which you haven't heard of. Like, you'll be passing on songs and memes and dance videos of places and of languages that you don't understand, of places you haven't heard of, of people you haven't heard of, because that's the kind of age we live in now. So, of course, there are pros and cons to it. Like, because it's so open, it's very competitive. Like, there's a lot of competition and things keep changing all the time. It's very dynamic. And every new day, you see a new thing coming up. But at the same time, I think now it really doesn't matter where you are from. Like, if you can post something on the internet, if you have good ideas, and if you're courageous enough to put it out, I think it really helps. So if I had to
The world
talk
has
about
become
myself,
smaller.
it's become smaller. If I had to talk about myself, in spite of being in Bombay, I'm not a person who socializes much. I'm quite an introvert, in fact. So it really depends on the person. You can be in any place. You can be, you can be in the hub of the where everything is working, and you might still not be using those opportunities, or you might be somewhere far off, but you're so you're able to kind of socialize so well with people that you'll make things happen. So it really depends on your personality, is
Who
what
person
I
to
say.
person?
Yeah, what kind of person you are. And so for me, I think because being an introvert, I don't socialize much, and I don't network much. And yeah, I'm pretty much like thinking more about creating, and ठीक है ये कैसे मैं प्रमोट करूँ, या ये कैसे मैं इंटरनेट पे डालूँ, या व्हाट शुड आई पोस्ट नेक्स्ट. इट्स दैट काइंड ऑफ अ थिंग. सो आई थिंक दैट इज माय, इफ आई हैड टू लाइक पॉइंट आउट माय स्ट्रगल, वन इज दैट लाइक बीइंग एन इंट्रोवर्ट. एंड सेकेंड इज आई थिंक लाइक हैविंग अ टीम. व्हाट हैपेंस इज व्हेन यू आर पोस्टिंग समथिंग ऑन यूट्यूब, पीपल सी द वीडियो, बट देयर्स सो मच बैक एंड वर्क दैट्स हैपनिंग. लाइक You need to record something. You need to ideate it. You need to have a good video to it. So that when you say a good video, you need a DOP, a director. You need color correction. You need DI. You need all those things. And when I talk about a good audio, you need a studio. You need a good producer. You need a good mix engineer. So there's so much going on behind. And as an independent artist, what happens is like you're a freelancer, and many a times you don't get the same team to work for you for whatever reasons, like either lack of availability, or you have a certain budget in your mind, or whatever it is, So having a team, I think, has also been a challenge to me. But
That's
like
true.
this was a challenge that I faced, like forming a team. Because, and specifically I wanted a team because I wanted to be able to resonate with the people I've worked with. And so that we are on the same page, and it doesn't take too much time to kind of there's not too much back and forth, and it doesn't take too much time to let them know what is there on my mind. So for me, that was a journey, like finding my people, like finding my tribe. That's how I would like to call it. Finding the people that I like to work with, and getting things done with them, and enjoying the whole process. So now, luckily, I really have a great audio team, a great video team, and I have Ben Thomas to look after the management. So this helps. Like so, for me, this has been the challenge, like getting a team, and getting and another challenge was like setting up my own band. So I, in fact, my band is from Chennai, so I travel every time to Chennai when I have a show. So yeah, that's
I
a
didn't know
different
this.
topic altogether. So now that we're talking about challenges and about being in a particular city and getting work done, I think I did a lot of work in Chennai because my band was from Chennai. So whenever we had a show, or for example, we had a show in Delhi, so I used to go like say 3 days before the show to Chennai, because majority, like if 4 to 5 band members are in one city, it makes more sense for me to
For
travel to
you to
that
go there.
place rather than have them come here and rehearse. So I used to go there, and now because of the lockdown, we don't
Of
do shows,
course
of course.
not.
But when this was happening, I used to go there and I rehearse with them. And from there, we fly out to whichever city we are performing in. And the reason why I chose Chennai was because I really loved the sound of the musicians over there. And I
That's
find them
true.
amazing. They're
They're on
technically
another
really
level.
amazing. Yeah, they really are another level, like when it comes to, yeah. So I really, really enjoyed doing those shows with them and stuff like that. So in spite of being from Bombay, I've actually done work in different cities. I've probably done more work in other cities, I can say. And my main the people who consume my music are mostly from Kerala, like which is again another place, like it's
Another
not
place.
yeah. So of course I do Hindi music and I have Hindi listeners, but the majority of the listeners that I have are in fact from are Malayalis. So this is when I realized that boundaries don't actually define what you create, like where you are
That's
from,
true.
where you come from, what you do. It at After a point of time, it stops mattering. It's about what you're
It's
doing
also
and
the
you create.
soul, like I mean you when I look at it, when I look at your music, for me everything is nice regardless of the language because I'm looking at this as music, right? But like you say that you have more fans in from Kerala. It's not because you're singing Malayalam, there are other singers also who sing Malayali. Of course, there are tons of people, right? But there is a
Correct, yeah.
vibe that every musician and every artist gives out a certain vibe, right? So I guess your vibe might be closer to to somebody who really understands Malayali. But for us, the amazement is like I'm like I don't understand anything except Hindi and English. But I've listened to so Ben and I go like really long way back, really long way back when he used to work with Sonu Nigamji. You know, yeah, so that's the, I mean, we did a show together at the BBC. I used to be with BBC, and from then, Ben is one person that I've actually the only one, maybe if I could say that publicly, that I really look up to as an artist manager. You know, I've always seen him putting in so much of
effort,
so much of care, so much of respect into the artist that he works with, and as much with the person. Like, I mean, I was a client for him, you know. So, I mean, both ways that he does that. I feel the industry needs like good talent managers, because the artist,
absolutely,
it's so difficult for an artist to just manage. Like, you can move between one language to another because that's your skill. You know, that of course Ben can't do, and he better not do. But just to be able to guide you in that.
Yeah,
that's well, absolutely so much...
that conviction is so important, and he has that. You know, he is so dedicated, and he really believes in his artists. And
yeah,
I don't think there will be a person like him who can, you know, really understand what an artist is and how and what should be done with an artist, and how far can an artist go, like seeing the potential of an artist and things like that.
Yeah,
it's not just, you know, about getting shows for the artist or anything, but it's about positioning the artist, and you know, and how and where that artist will shine. And what can be done so that, you know, things can get better? I think that thought process is something which he's a boss.
And it's not. It sounds damn simple that okay, as a manager, you
it's
do
not
that.
Not but at all.
It's damn, and the entire career of an artist depends on that.
Absolutely, I agree with you.
Yeah. So let's take a musical break. And what's on your mind? What can we hear from you? Sorry, being
let's do something. Okay, so I will do something from one of my songs for that I sung for Sachin Jigar, this movie called Meri Pyari Bindu. I'll just do a couple of lines of that.
Sure.
And then I'll go on to some others.
Yeah, just as much as you want to.
Yeah. Dhani si, sharpati pani si. धीरे धीरे से तेरी चाहत चढ़ती है, थोड़ी नादानी सी थोड़ी शैतानी सी, धीमे धीमे से तेरी आदत बढ़ती है, तो मेरे रूबरू मैं क्या करूं, यकीन नहीं आता शाम से सुबह करूं, देखा करूं रहा भी नहीं जाता, अफीमी 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 है ये प्यार, अफीमी है तेरा मेरा प्यार, खुमारी खुमारी नाए रे करार, अफीमी है तेरा मेरा प्यार, सांसों में तेरी नजदीकियों का इत्र तू घोल दे, मैं ही क्यों इश्क जाहिर करूं, तू भी कभी बोल दे, लेके जा नहीं जाएगा मेरी कातिल, हर तेरा बहाना हुआ तुझसे ही शुरू तुझ पे ही खत्म, मेरे इश्क का फसाना हुआ तू शम्मा है, तो याद रखना मैं भी हूं परवाना, ओ जालमा जो तेरे खातिर तड़पे पहले से ही, क्या उसे तड़पाना, ओ जालमा ओ जालमा ओ जालमा ओ जालमा ओ जालमा
ओ जालिमा, लवली.
Thank you.
The versatility is just so great. But you've been learning classical for a really long time, for ever since childhood, right? But now that
I
you've
started.
moved so much to playback and so much to covers and stuff, I heard that you back again. You're learning again now, like you started all over again.
I wouldn't say it's all over again, but it's like an extension to what I have been learning. I was learning Hindustani classical when I was in school. But I think a lot of that learning is very mindless because, you're in school and you're like, okay, अभी खेलना है, अभी रियाज करना है, अभी पढ़ाई करना है. Like, it's very mixed up generally. It's not very focused. And now I really felt like, there are certain things I want to revisit, but with a different perspective. Because back then it was just like, rote learning, like anything. Like गला चलता था लेकिन दिमाग नहीं चलता था वैसा. तो फॉर दैट रीजन आई थॉट आई शुड ज्वाइन अगेन. एंड नाउ आई एम लर्निंग फ्रॉम सुनील बोरगांवकर जी, हिंदुस्तानी क्लासिकल. सो व्हेन वी डू अ राग वी टेक अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम. लाइक पहले व्हेन आई यूज्ड टू डू समथिंग, इट वाज वेरी सिलेबस काइंड ऑफ थिंग. लाइक कि इन अ ईयर वील फिनिश सिक्स राग्स एंड वील हैव एन एग्जाम एंड थिंग्स लाइक दैट. बट व्हिच मेड सेंस बैक देन बिकॉज एज अ स्टूडेंट यू इफ यू देयर इज नो स्ट्रक्चर देन यू जस्ट डोंट नो व्हाट टू डू. And especially at that age, where as kids, no one can actually make us sit down and do anything, वैसा. So that structure and that competition and that exam, हाँ, ये pressure, वो सब चाहिए था तब जाके कुछ
There's a
हो पाता है,
perspective with
वैसा.
that.
But now I wanted to learn in depth. So now the sir that I learn with, he is also a painter, he's a singer, he does so many things. He's an artist and he correlates all art forms so beautifully. And when we do a rag, like I did Yaman Rag for almost 4 to 5 months. So there's no time limit to something. And the class goes on for, say, 2 hours or 3 hours. Or generally, we have like a 45-minute session and it ends over there, right? Like everything has an end. But if something is going, then it keeps going. And every Friday, So that's how I've adopted a very different system of learning now, which is just flowing. And there is no judgment, no time limits, just learn. So
Just
that's what I
learn.
wanted to do. Because
That is what the
professional.
classical music provides us. Like it's as you, the lifetime is less. You can actually just be going.
Exactly. And professionally, what happens is because there are so many things happening around that it sometimes it drowns out what you want to do and like what you want to learn and things like that. So parallelly, I think it's always nice to have something, even if you're not using it commercially. In fact, you use it commercially but very indirectly, where people won't know how it is used. But because you're understanding the thought process, you use it in your songs. So as an outcome, people will understand that there is progress, but they will not know what has been done. So that's what learning helps you with, the back end.
And it reflects,
So I'm learning.
like I said, it reflects in your music very clearly. I mean, not that any of us can comprehend that what is the constitution of that, but it doesn't matter. We don't have to. Like we our job is to enjoy the music. We better not get
That's
into
how I
doing
want it
that.
to be. I want my music to be accessible. I don't want anyone to think, यार ये क्या गा रही है, मुझे कुछ समझ में नहीं आ रहा. I don't want that. I try and keep things very simple. And in no way I try to, whatever I've learned, it's for me to, first of all, enjoy. When I make something, I should be able to enjoy it. And I want my listeners to, feel very relaxed when they listen to my music. I don't want anyone to get confused about what's happening and,
And you do that awesomely well. You do that
Thank you.
really,
Thank
really
you so
well.
much.
It
Thank you.
is a fan moment for me personally to be sitting across and talking with you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
So will it be possible to hear something from you on the classical side since
Sure, sure, sure. So I use this app called iTabla Pro. This is where
Everybody does
so
that. Everybody does that.
so every Friday I have a video call class with my professor, with my sir. I'm calling him professor. Money heist. So I have this video call class with him, and I generally use my Bluetooth speaker, and I'll just go with the same setup now while singing this. So this is a tarana. A tarana basically doesn't have words. It's just I'll sing it. I think better than telling anything I should sing.
Lovely.
Thank you.
How is it? You know, all of us have inspirations in life, but you know, sometimes I feel that there are people that we are not just in awe of them, but they make like a much more soulful impact on who we become as a person. It's not just being fans of, you know, like, I mean, I could be a fan for the music that you perform, but it's more soulful. Have you had any such connections in your journey and that could possibly reflect?
So while you were asking the question, that face just appeared in front of my eyes. So that's why I was smiling throughout. It is Rehman sir, Rehman sir, Rehman sir, Rehman sir, forever. He has been the reason why I wanted to do music, like professionally, because I was like, okay, I really want to know or be a part of something so beautiful, like, you know, the creation and how something so beautiful can be created at all. This is to always, this was the thought that went on in my mind, even as a kid when I heard his music. And he has been my biggest inspiration for, you know, for getting into this field and for, and everything that he stands for, whether it is, you know, beauty, experimentation, every damn thing. Like I follow each and every thing of that, and, you know, and I think I was really, really privileged to get this opportunity to meet him and work with him.
How was that? I mean, I know it's a very journalistic question. Like, I forgive me for that. But what I mean is, like, when somebody's so important and you get to not just like watch the person, but be with that person, create something, and then be in the process of creation. Apart from being just like passed out on that, what else happened to you?
I just passed out, I guess. I was literally, like, I didn't know. I was very, very nervous. I was blank. I was breathless. Like, it was almost, I was like, am I in a studio or am I in a hospital? What exactly is happening?
Mr. Rehman being the doctor and you're in the hospital.
That was crazy when he entered, and I'm like, and he's so, he's very silent, but his aura is so, you know, you can feel it when he's in the room. That's how it is. So once he entered, and then he told me to, like, you know, sing in different styles. And I was very nervous, and I told him that. He's like, why are you nervous? Just take your time and do it. And his engineers, you know, were also there. And they also, you know, helped me ease calm into down. The process. Yeah, and calm down. And then I sang a few songs in different styles. I think that was for them, for Sir, to understand, like, you know, what are the kind of songs I sing and what are the kind of styles I do. And then after that, that day itself, we recorded for Mohenjo-daro, and Javed Saab was there, Ashutosh Ji was there. And, you know, I didn't know if it would make it to the final or not, because we generally don't know, right? Once we do a song for playback, we don't know if it goes to the final or not. But when it made it to the final, I was like, oh my God, I just couldn't believe it, because it's a duet with Rehman sir. And, you know, it was, I won't call it an experience, or, you know, it was not something for me. It's so pure that it was not something that I wanted to happen because I wanted a push in my career. It was something that I wanted since childhood, that moment, wanting to meet him and sing something for him. Whether it was, it's definitely for any singer, that's like the ultimate dream, to work with Rehman sir. And what can it do to your career? And of course, because there's so much of love for Rehman sir. So when you're associated with him, people love it. People love to know what you've done with him. But for me, it was always much more than that. It was much more than having like an impetus in my career or anything. But for me, it was this sacred moment to having to be in the same room to meet him and, to learn whatever I can in that little time. So I think that's what is how I would define this experience as, the learning that I went through.
That's so honest. Absolutely. Like I relate to each part of it. That's so true. I mean, when you get an opportunity to be with a legend like that, I mean, just thinking of the career is like cutting it too short, like super short. You know, just
It's
think
much
about
more than
that.
that. It's
It's like, I mean, career ka to वैसे भी कोई गारंटी नहीं है. Like, I mean, नथिंग कैन गारंटी एनीथिंग, लाइक विच वे वन गोज, और बट इट्स लाइक व्हाट यू कैन पिक अप फ्रॉम पर्सन लाइक दैट इन दैट मोमेंट इज
करेक्ट.
लव.
Being in the same room itself, and whatever he told, I paid attention to it. What was he saying? What was he doing? Getting to watch him work itself was a big thing for me. And I went to Chennai also to do a Tamil song for him. So there I stayed for 13 days. So that was also like an amazing period of learning, getting to, go to the studio and trying new songs and things like that, So I think it's the learning that I took away from this more than anything.
Yeah, and it doesn't happen to everybody, Sana. I'm sure you know that. So
I
whatever you
thank God
put
for
in
that all the
your
time.
heart.
I said I really thank God for such a thing to happen, because there are so many talented people out there, and it's I
On
just
their own.
believe it's a blessing.
Lovely. So I mean, we've heard the Mohenjodaro song for sure, but is there what's is there something more diverse that, or something that we haven't heard yet that we can hear from you?
Haven't heard yet. Okay, what can I sing? Let me think of it. I think I'll end with a Malayalam song, because I'm guessing majority of the viewers here are Malayalis.
Yeah, if
So,
I just read out, so
and they'll be telling me to sing Kannadi Kudum Kuti, I'm so sure.
Kannadi
That'll be a
Kodam Kodi for
request.
sure, and then there's Afrin, so there's a
Afrin. Okay,
request
we
for.
can do Afrin also. We can do
Okay,
both the songs actually.
yeah, let's do both.
Let me just set the tantra. ऐसा देखा नहीं खूबसूरत कोई, जिस्म जैसे अजंता की मूरत कोई, जिस्म जैसे निगाहों पे जादू कोई, जिस्म नगमा कोई, जिस्म खुशबू कोई, जिस्म जैसे मचलती हुई रागनी, जिस्म जैसे महकती हुई चांदनी, जिस्म जैसे खिलता हुआ एक चमन, जिस्म जैसे सूरज की पहली किरण, जिस्म तरशा हुआ दिलकशो दिलनशी, संदली संदली मरमरी मरमरी, हुस्ने जाना की तारीफ मुमकिन नहीं, हुस्ने जाना की तारीफ मुमकिन नहीं, आफरी 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 आफरी, तू भी देखे अगर तो कहे हम नशे, आफरी 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 आफरी, उसने जाना कि तारीफ मुमकिन नहीं, उसने जाना कि तारीफ मुमकिन So that was Afreen for all you guys. And now we have the final song for the evening. கண்ணாடி கூடும் கூட்டி கண்ணுதி பொட்டும் குட்டி காவலம் பைங்கிழி வாயோ குஞ்ஞாற்ற பெண்ணினுடுக்காய் குடமுள்ள கொடியுமாய் கூதியும் குரவியும் வாயோ மழையும் மஞ்சளே முளையும் கூடலே அழகும் நீயோரம் குமிரும் கனவல்லே மனவாளன் வந்து விழிச்சாளம் கொள்ளும் மனசல்லே கண்ணாடி கூடும் கூட்டி கண்ணெழுதி பொட்டும் குத்தி காவள பைங்கிழிவாயோ பூவின் புல்லாங்குழலின் பெண்ணி நீ மூளை உணர்த்தும் பாட்டின் பல்லவிழ்ந்தே காதிலோதுமோ நெல்லி நீ சிறு நிலாவின் உள்ளே நின் முத்து பொழிக்கும் புன்னாறு காற்று கவிழ்ப்பூ நுள்ளி நோக்கியோ ஆறும் காணாதென்னுள் ஓரோ மோகம் பூக்கும் ஈழத்தில் பாடி பூங்குள் கண்ணாடி கூடும் கூட்டி கண்ணெழுதி பொட்டும் குத்தி காவலம் பைங்கிழிவாயோ குஞ்ஞாற்ற பெண்ணினுடுக்காய் குடமுள்ள கோடியுமாய் கோதியும் குறுகியும் வாயோ
Sana, how much you enjoy each song that you sing. I've been just observing you at the back end. How much you're smiling through each song that you're performing, like how? It's so
Thank you. Thank you so much. I hope you enjoyed it as well.
I think you can see it here. And totally. Like I said, honestly, and you can check this with Ben. I can only be nasty, but I can't really be nice to people. He knows this. But when I am, then I really am. But I've been a fan of your work and
Thank you
been
so much.
Closely following it. And it's been like so nice just watching you so candidly and hearing you so candidly. And more
Thank
special,
you.
You know, the music is there. Music we've been following, but more special is to know you as a person and to know where you're coming from and what you think means a lot.
Thank you so much. I really had this was a very unique conversation. Like I've not been so open or honest. I have been honest, not that, but it's just a very long conversation because generally internet we try to keep it very short. Like it's for free in 20 minutes, but for 1 hour I think like we spoke quite a lot and. I said a lot of things that I generally don't, get an opportunity to share with my audience. And thank you for creating that platform for me, for being able to, share this.
Yeah, that's the small thing that Maitri Project is all about. I mean, baat to karni chahiye na. Baatein to karni chahiye na hum ek dusre se.
Aur kaafi baat ki humne.
Haan, but...
Achhi baatein ki aur samjha nahi time kaise pass hua in fact.
Haan, but mujhe wohi lagta hai, pata hai, like in the television ki dunia aur mein hum log itna sara time pakad ke chalte hai na, 22 minutes, 28 minutes.
Haan, ye hota hai, 15, 20.
Haan, wo thik hai, wo sab slot thik hai, but like when it's... ऐसा भी क्या हो गया लाइक आई ऑलवेज टेल पीपल व्हेन व्हेन दे टॉकिंग अबाउट म्यूजिक कौन सा म्यूजिक है कौन सा सिंगर है मैं वही बोलती हूँ क्या फर्क पड़ता है सुन लो You know, like it's like
Correct.
Another person. It's music. It's just like great. So we have Mr. Menon here, who's like a very, very is a dear friend, and he's saying, "I just realized you're a Malayali." Baba, खुल गया tube light. Yes.
जी हाँ, बिल्कुल हम मल्लू हैं मलयाली हैं full on.
Lovely, Sana. Today, yes, we let you go, but not for good. We're going to have you back again whenever This is your
Sure.
audience, Anna. This is your stage. Whenever you want to bring anything to us and you want to check how's it doing, how's it going, we'll set this up
Definitely, I'll
together
do.
for you. And
Sure,
we
sure,
would
sure.
love to have you back again.
Super.
All the best. Stay versatile.
Thank you so
Stay
much.
so amazing.
Thank you. Thank you.
And
Thank
take
you.
care
I
of
really
yourself.
had a good time and thank you for having me on your on the Maitri
Great.
project.
The pleasure is totally ours. Thank you. Thank you,
Thank
Ben.
you.
I know you're watching there. We'll catch up with you soon. Thank you. So, audience, that was our super special surprise. Yes, we did just hear Sana, real time Sana we heard. And I hope you enjoyed and you will notice the versatility that she comes across with. That is what we appreciate. And in an artist, when they do so much of work and they don't get limited to just something that, you know, like they know that this works, bikta hai, acha chalta hai, not just there. But I've always followed her for seeing how much she puts in effort to every part of it, not just music. And I think the first thing that she said right at the beginning of the show, that how she produced the video in the lockdown, one may not need to, right? One may just say that, okay, I'm thinking and I'm creating. But she did all the way ahead and she enjoyed the process. So hats off to all independent artists. We know that it's a struggle. We know that it's a process and there is a lot of structures that we don't have, worldwide we don't have, and even more so in India. But well, we got to do it. We got to do it because we got to keep the art alive. So thank you for being a part of the Maitri project. Thank you for hearing us out. We will be back soon with yet another amazing independent artist. Keep watching, keep following our channels. You'll get all the updates therein and write to us. Thank you. Bye-bye. Good evening.